系噶。Excuse me. Could you spare a dollar, ma'am? Just trying to get a little gas money.
Yeah. Here. Take
care. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.
Definitely a boy.
He always says that.
You failed that kick, babe? He's going to World Cup 2035.
Hey. I don't care as long as it's healthy.
Hey, amen.
And as cute as Allison. You got your shotgun yet, man? Those boys are going to be sneaking around before you know it.
Don't got to worry about that. I got to sign up for karate, judo, kung fu, and what's that thing with the sticks?
She has them wrapped around her little finger.
You know she does.
So...You guys are actually gonna wait, right?
Yeah, we talked about it, man. We'd rather be a surprise.
I totally understand that. I think we're gonna do that this time around, too.
What?
No way. Seriously?
Whoops.
You son of a gun, man. How come you didn't say anything? Congratulations,
bro. When are you due?
September.
Aw, play dates.
Look at us. All grown up, mortgages and kids.
And bad knees.
I tell us.To family.
And friends.
Salud.
Salud. Yeah.
It's good wine. It's...
I wouldn't know.
She can barely keep her eyes open.
I know. She really didn't get a nap today.
What you looking at?
Just looking.
Well, they have a changing table that actually changes the baby, huh?
Yeah, right. You wish.
You see something you like?
Sure. How about the $2,000 crib?
Mm.
Or the $1,500 jogging stroller?
Yeah, hey. I mean, you know, work a little more overtime and maybe.
Maybe what? Maybe you'll come home a little more tired than you already do?
Mm.
No, thank you. We'll be fine. We'll be fine with what we already have.
Well, you know, Allison got her stuff secondhand, so I guess it'll be third hand for the new baby.
And then if we keep it long enough, it'll be antique. And then we could sell it for a fortune.
That won't be forever, baby.
I know.
I mean, you know, pay down on some of that debt will be better. I just don't want you to worry.
Do I look worried?
You look good.
Thank
I love you.
You too. I love you. I guess.
So what? That's supposed to, I guess.
I mean, I'm saying, you're okay. You're okay.
To Paul Rogers at the People's Trust Bank.
People's Trust Bank out of Atlanta surprised a lot of people with the announcement that they've accepted a merger bid from the First National Bank of Los Angeles. Financial sources report that if the merger is approved, it can lead up to a loss of 3,000 jobs, with most of those cuts happening in California, Arizona, and Texas.
Hey, Dad, sorry, there's not much more I can tell you.
Ted, what does this mean for Atlanta?
I'm sorry, no comment. I'm not at liberty to discuss that.
So when's the merger going to happen?
I told you, no comment. The people in Los Angeles would be happy to answer all your questions. You need to talk to them.
In other news, Penn
Chemical
talked about its fourth quarter analysis.
I don't know.
And its projections for the upcoming fiscal year.
I don't know.
Love you.
Love you too. Oh, babe, remember I want us to have dinner together? Baby!
Hey, I thought it was just rumors.
They were. At first, but things got serious real fast.I just found out about it a couple weeks ago myself. I would have told you, but they swore us to secrecy.
Unbelievable.
It's just business, David.
So what do we do now?
They're moving fast. They're going to start with closing our L.A. office.
Just like that, the whole thing, we have no say in it.
Afraid not. Look, I'm going to need you to fly out there right away. Start the ball rolling on this.
You mean start the axe dropping out? Ted, I built the whole department in L.A. I handpicked those people.
I know this is tough for you, David, but I think it's best they hear it from you. we start with these. What about me? I'm sure you're fine.
This sucks, Ted.
I'll have Susan book your flight.
Yeah.
Mr. Light, the first gentleman's here.
All right, send him in. How are you, sir? Hey, good to see you, sir. Have a seat. I know it's kind of spur of the moment, man. As you know, there's been a lot of cutbacks in the company. Unfortunately, we're going to have to phase out your branch in the company, and we'll be no longer be needing your services here. I am very sorry.
That's not fair.
So I'm looking at your resume. Stellar. Unfortunately, we're having to phase out your branch of the company, so your services will no longer be needed. I regret to give you this information. But seeing as your resume, I'm sure you won't have another problem getting another job, and we'll be more than happy to give you a favorable recommendation. We no longer need your services. I am sorry. I am truly sorry. Ted. So, you're working late?
Yeah, unfortunately. How'd it go?
How do you think?
Not bad, huh?
I just hope this merger is worth it. What it's doing to all these people.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too. I'm trying to take it out on you. I just want to get this behind me so I can get back to my real job.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Listen, David, I don't know quite how to say this.
Say what?
I just got off the phone, and they're making some more changes. I swear, I did not see this coming.
Wait a minute.
They promised me. They said your job was safe.
You're firing me?
It's not me, David. It's First National. They're cutting back everywhere. It's not personal.
Yeah, it's just business, right, Ted?
Come on. You know it's not like that. If it was up to me...
They know it. That's why they sent me here to fire these people. Because I was next on the hatchet list.
It sure looks that way, yeah. Listen, I got you 3 months severance, full pay plus health care.
3 months won't cut it, Ted.
What do you mean?
Trish is pregnant. She's due in September.
Oh, God. David, I don't know what to say. Listen, let me try to get an extension.
Come in on Monday and we'll figure out, okay?
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Go ahead.
What can I get you?
Chutney, please.
What do you recommend?
I don't know. It's my first time here.
Oh. Well, you're no help. Not a good day?
Not by a long shot.
I'm Amy, by the way.
I'm David.
Nice to meet you, David.
Nice to meet you.
Where are you from?
Atlanta.
Hmm. You're far from home.
It comes with the territory.
I know what you mean. My husband travels a lot. We're in Santa Barbara, but we always stay here when we're in L.A. He actually makes it out to your neck of the woods sometimes.
What's he do?
Project manager, which I gather means whatever he wants it to mean.
Yeah, busy guy.
Oof. 9 to 5s are for sissies. We're actually supposed to meet tonight, but he canceled already.
My wife's in the same boat.
Please tell me you at least call her, though, when you're gonna be late.
I try.
Good for you, David. She's adorable.
Yeah, she's a sweetheart, too.
How old?
Almost 3 years old.
Mm-hmm. She has your smile.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
You think so, huh?
Definitely. You're a lucky man.
I know.
He says he's not ready. He wants to focus on his career. And I get that. But it's been 8 years, and he knows I want to have kids.
You should talk to him.
Believe me, I have. I'm beginning to think that maybe he just doesn't want to have kids with me.
Hey, come on, don't say that. He'd be crazy not to.
It's the truth.
Look at you. You're beautiful, you're kind, you're patient. He's lucky to have you. You tell him I said so.
You're not so bad yourself.
I really don't get it. How can they do that? Just 16 years? 16 years, and just like that, you're out of a job.
I know, it doesn't make sense. You know, sometimes companies merge, and there's a redundancy in the workforce to cut to.
David, I know. What are you talking about? I know how these things work, okay? I watch the news. I'm talking about the fact that this is happening to us.
I'm sorry, I know you're right. I'm still trying to wrap my head around it myself.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, baby, but I mean, what are we gonna do? I mean, we have another baby on the way. We have the mortgage. We're already in over our heads.
I'm gonna talk to Ted first thing Monday morning, and I'll see if he can give us, you know, a little bit more on the severance. Yeah?
Still not gonna cover us through September.
We'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Now, right now, we have enough for 3 months. You know, between that and the 401k, that'll give me enough time to find another job.
You think we'll be okay? Just please tell me that you think we're gonna be okay.
We're gonna be okay.
Yeah?
Yeah, I promise.
Okay. Thanks, man.
There you go, man.
Sorry to hear about your job.
Yeah, I should have seen it coming, you know? Only thing they care about is the bottom line.
Well, they're making a huge mistake letting you go.
Maybe you should tell them that.
You know what? Maybe I could talk to my boss, put in a good word for you. They're always looking for good salespeople.
Yeah, I kind of want to look around first, you know? See what's out there.
All right, well, you let me know if you change your mind.
I will, man, thanks.
Yeah.
Hello?
David?
Who's this?
It's Amy. How are you?
Amy, hi.
Got the grill going.
So nice to hear your voice.
I'm kind of in the middle of something right now, so it's not a good time.
Oh, I won't keep you. I just wanted to let you know my husband's going to be in Atlanta for a few days. I was thinking of tagging along. Maybe we could grab some coffee?
Listen, that night was a mistake, okay?
David, I'm not trying to make your life complicated. It's just that night. It's been such a long time since I connected with someone like that.
It's not a good idea, okay? It's just not a good idea.
You're right. Take care.
You too. Put out a couple feelers. Might be interested.
All right.
Hey.
Uh-huh. Hey.
Hey. Got him to go to 4 months on the severance, including benefits. I know it's not quite enough to take you up to Trisha's due date, but you can extend. And...
I appreciate the extension, Ted.
Give her my best, will you? And tell her not to worry. You'll be back in the saddle before she knows it.
I'll do that.
Can I help you with that?
I got it.
All right, then.
Take care, Ted.
You too. If you need anything, you call me. I mean it.
I will.
Rob, come in.
Rob White, First National.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, man.
Please have a seat.
Thank you.
How was your flight?
Just fine. Thanks for asking. Got a nice setup here, Ted.
Thank you. We think so too. We're just a little concerned about some of the changes.
Believe me, I understand.
Hope so. I just had to let go of one of my best managers, a personal friend too.
Well, stay in touch with him because when the dust settles, we may be hiring some of these folks back.
I hope so.
So, you ready to get started?
Sure thing.
All right.
I was making some notes here based on your suggestions.
Yeah, your order's ready.
Hey, Dad.
Hello there.
Amy?
Hi.
What are you doing here?
Believe me, I'm not stalking you. I told you my husband was flying in. I decided to come along anyway. I'm waiting for him right now. He's waiting.
Oh, wow.
How are you?
I'm good.
Yeah. David, this order's ready. Do you have a minute? We could grab a table?
You know, I actually gotta go. I'm in a hurry, but...
Listen, you're right about that night. It never should have happened. But we're both grown-ups, and you don't have to worry about me getting all weird or anything.
I appreciate that.
We had a really nice talk, and I really like that. I'd like to think we could talk again sometime.
Yeah, listen, Amy, I enjoyed speaking to you as well. And if the situation were different, then... I gotta go. This is for my wife, right?
Goodbye, David.
Goodbye, Amy. Yes, this is David Life. I was trying to get in contact with Jonathan Abrams in regard to a position you guys had available there. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. All right. Yes, could I speak with Kenneth Zimmerman, please? Okay, is there someone in HR that I could speak to, possibly? It may have been filled. Okay. When were you planning on telling me that? Because I've spoke to you every day this week.
I don't...
You're not even going to say goodbye?
I thought you were still asleep. Hey, look, don't worry about dinner. Probably going to be late, all right?
You mean like every other day? Rob, I'm sorry. I don't want to fight. I was hoping we could talk.
About what?
I don't know. It doesn't matter. Just talk. The way we used to. I get lonely sometimes.
Go to the club. Go see your friends.
No, I mean for you. Let's take a trip. Let's get away.
You know I can't do something like that right now.
Just for a few days.
Look, I'm up to my elbows in this merger. I can't do something like that for at least another month. Oh,
please, Rob.
Oh, come on. Hey, babe, my suit. I got a meeting in like a half an hour. Listen, as soon as this merger is complete, we can take a trip. Go wherever you want.
Maybe I'll just go back down to L.A. That was fun.
L.A.?
You don't even have a clue, do you?
What?
A sleeping pill and a drink and you're dead to the world. You don't even realize if I'm around or not.
What are you talking about?
Let's just say I wasn't lonely all night.
Are you saying you had an affair?
One night hardly qualifies as
a... Who is he?
It's none of your business.
Who is he?
He's someone that I met at the bar. Are you happy now?
I'll find out who it is.
That's perfect. Really. You don't have time to take me to dinner, to plan our anniversary, to have a child? But let someone threaten your manhood and you've got all the time in the world! Don't be late for your meeting, dear. Have a good day.
It's not a spaceship.
What is it?
It's a house spaceship.
Oh, it's a house spaceship. Oh. Thanks, Mommy.
Hey.
You got any more?
Some more in the car, babe.
Okay.
Thanks. Hello? Sure, who's calling? Okay, hang on one sec. Hey, babe, I think it's somebody calling about a job. Somebody named Amy?
Uh-oh.
Mr. Bill Collector.
Let me take it in there. Amy.
David?
I'm sorry to bother you. I know what we said.
Amy, this is my home.
I called your cell.
Why'd you block my number?
You know why. You cannot call me. Do not call my home.
I know. I needed someone to talk to.
Okay, listen. I'm hanging up now. Do not call here anymore.
David, please. That night was so special to me.
Goodbye, Amy.
The way we met and spent the night together,
it made me feel so alive again. David. David, please. David, I just need to talk to you. David, please.
I'm not gonna get upset. I am not gonna hurt this baby.
Trisha was.
I trusted you. I believed in you. You were my world. I want you to go.
Trisha, let me.
I need to think and I can't even look at you.
Hey.
Hey, David.
Hey, man. Sorry to bother you. Look, her car is here. Is she staying with you? You know, I've been driving by the house. I've been calling her nonstop for the past 3 days. And
this isn't a good time.
I just need to talk to her, man. Just look, I messed up, okay? Yeah. Now, listen. I love my family, okay? You know they're my world. Would you just tell Trish? There. Would you give her that? It's already endorsed.
Sure.
Supposed to trust him again?
Do you still love him?
Here you go, honey. A nice cup of hot tea.
Oh, thanks, Mom.
You're welcome, babe. That little girl is still asleep.
No, thank goodness. Sometimes her afternoon nap is the only thing that gets me through the rest of the day.
Well, I'm not surprised, because, honey, you're trying to do everything yourself, and it's hard enough without being pregnant. Trust me, I know.
But I'm doing okay.
Are you kidding me? You are doing great, honey. My only concern is what's going to happen after you have the baby. Have you thought about that?
That's pretty much all I think about.
Well, I really wish that you would reconsider. You know, we have plenty of room for all three of
you. I know, Mom, but I'm just not sure that's what I want to do right now.
Honey, that man betrayed you. Take it from me. I have been in your shoes. If it happens once, it will happen again. You can't trust him.
Mom, this is not the same. David isn't dead.
I don't see a bit of difference.
And you took Dad back. You gave him another chance, remember?
Look, and I live to regret it. Have you forgotten about that?
I'm just trying to keep my family together.
Honey, I know David has been a good father and he's been a good husband. The fact of the matter is he cheated on you, and it will happen again. The trust is gone. It's gone.
I'm glad that both of you decided to continue with therapy. As I mentioned in our last session, it's important that you two spend time together. So tell me about your date night. How did that go?
It was fine.
Did you talk?
Yeah.
David.
Trish knows I love her and our children. But I hurt her deeply, and, it's hard for her to forgive me.
I can't pretend like nothing happened.
You said that you wanted to work this out. Is that still true?
Yeah, but every time things start to feel normal, I just remember all over again, and I realize things can change just like that.
Last week, we spoke about forgiveness and how letting go is the first step.
Yeah, I know.
But why do you find it so hard for you to let go?
I don't know.
It's her mother.
What? David, please. Leave her out of this.
I will if you will.
David?
My father cheated on her more than once. You know that. It's a little hard to just forget everything he put her through.
And you're afraid that David will do the same thing?
That's the problem. I find it hard to believe that he won't.
How goes the job search?
Not so great.
Well, you know, my offer still stands.
Thanks, man. Have you talked to Trisha?
Not really. I mean, she's been out of the house a couple of times to see Cindy, but...
How's she doing?
Okay. You know.
Yeah, she missed the last few sessions with Dr. Yates, you know. Tried to call her, and, I thought we were making progress, you know. I don't think she's gonna be able to forgive me on this one. What?
Nothing.
What's that look? Tell me.
Oh, you're a good guy, David. Now, I think you should know this. Trisha and Cindy were talking. She's gonna file for divorce. She wants to do it before the baby comes.
Come back for the rest of my stuff in the morning.
Okay.
Hey, give Daddy a hug. Love you so much. Bye, Pumpkin.
Hope you're proud of yourself.
Mom.
What kind of man
Mom,
does
Mom, please, could you take Allison upstairs, please?
Good baby.
Thank you.
I don't think she likes me.
No.
Can I come by sometime? No, just to see Allison. I'll call first.
Okay.
Doesn't have to be like this.
I gotta tell you, Ted, I like the way it's all coming together. I appreciate your help the last few months making it work, too.
Well, thank you, Rob. That's good to hear.
How's it feel at your end?
Well, we're holding our own down here, but my people are starting to feel a little stretched.
Well, it's probably time we get you guys some help. What do you need?
Well, I need analysts, managers, and not just contractors. So we need to hire some full-time bodies.
Well, that may take some time.
Well, maybe not. You remember that guy I told you about? David Life is his name. He's a team leader, one of our best.
Think he's still available?
I can certainly find out.
All right, well, I'll be down next week. I'd like to meet him.
Okay, great. I'll set it up.
David, you said you were going to take care of this.
Look, I talked to the bank. They said they would give me more time, okay?
Well, that's not what this letter says. I mean, you have to do something. You have to pay something. They're going to throw us out.
Trish, I don't have it. I don't have it.
What are we supposed to do? Where are we supposed to live?
Just don't worry. I will take care of this.
Yeah, that's what you said last time.
All right, look. Ted called. He said the bank is rehiring and they want to talk to me.
Really?
The guy from California is flying in for a meeting. They want me back.
Well, that's great.
So look, I will talk to the bank about our situation and I just don't want you to worry. All right, I'll make this right.
Okay, well, good luck.
Thank you.
All right.
I need to double check my March statements. Mm-hmm. How do I access my call history? Okay. Yep.
Hi. I'm David Life. I have an 8:30 appointment with Mr. Rob White.
Thank you. Yes.
Mr. White, your 8:30 appointment is here. David Life.
I'll be right with him.
If you'd like to have a seat, he'll be right with you.
Okay, thank you. Good morning.
David Life. Sorry I'm not in right now, but if you leave your name and number, I'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks.
Mr. White? Yes, sir. I'll send him in. Mr. Life, he's ready for you now.
Okay.
It's going to be the last door at the end of the hall.
All right, thank you.
You're welcome.
Rob?
Hey. David Life, sir.
David, come on in.
Pleasure to meet you. Shall we?
Please.
So I
brought another copy of my resume.
You liaisoned with the L.A. branch while you worked here.
I did. That's right. Yep.
Spent a lot of time out there?
A few days a month. You know, back and forth whenever needed.
Made some friends, though.
Well, it's L.A., so...
Yeah. It's a friendly town, right?
They can be.
Does the name Amy ring a bell?
Amy?
My wife.
Oh, God. Rob, listen. Listen, I'm not like that, sir. It was a mistake.
What exactly do you think you can say to me right now that I would want to hear?
I didn't know.
You'll be hearing from us.
It was a mistake.
Yes?
Could you please ask security to come to the conference room and escort Mr. Life out?
Calling them now.
Thank you.
Dad. Hey, Dad.
Is it true? This is why you and Tricia split up.
Yeah.
You should have told me.
Dad, listen. I didn't know until I walked into the room.
I vouched for you. I sang your praises to high heaven.
That's a personal matter, not a professional one.
I've got to work with this guy.
Okay, look. Look. Just get me back in the room.
What?
Just get me back in the room. Let me explain to you.
You're serious.
Dad, I'm begging you.
Sorry, David. There's nothing I can do. You're on your own. Take care.
Come on, Ted. Ted! Ted!
David, what are you doing here? What do you want?
I want to see Trish.
She's resting.
Okay, then I can help.
We don't need your help.
Come on, not today, Joyce, okay? Now, there's something that I can do.
Haven't you done enough?
You ready to order?
Not right now. He'll be here in a minute. Hey, man. Hey, how's it going, man? Thanks for coming.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry I'm a little late.
No. You're good, man. I just got here a little bit early.
Cool. It's good to hear from you, man. It's been a while.
You too, man.
You getting my messages?
Yeah, I have. It's been kind of scattered a little bit, spread out a little bit, so.
You doing okay?
Yeah.
Excuse me. Are you going to order? You going to stay here a couple more hours?
We're going to order.
Okay.
I'm actually good, man.
Give us a minute. So what's going on, man? I went by the hotel that said you moved out.
Yeah. Had to tighten the belt a little bit. You know how it is.
Still don't work, huh?
Which is why I want to talk to you. I wanted to see if the offer still stood with your boss.
Yeah. I'll call him in the morning.
I would appreciate that.
Yeah. Come on, man. Let's eat. My treat. I'm kind of hungry.
You know what? I got to run. I got to make a couple more moves, but... Thank you. Appreciate it, man.
Right? David, you need anything, man?
Just give me a shot at that job, and I'll take it from there. All right? All right, buddy.
Take it easy, man.
Hey, man, what are you doing, man?
Let it go, man.
Hey, give it up.
Let it go.
Hey.
Excuse me, sir. Sorry to bother you. I'm kind of ran out of gas in my car here. I just wanted to know if I could borrow a dollar or two, just kind of get some gas and get home. I live across the town, sir. Sorry to bother you. Thank you, sir. Appreciate you. Thanks.
David, this is Cindy. Something's happened with Trisha and the baby. She's been taken to the hospital, David.
I got your message. What happened?
We're not sure.
Her blood pressure was high. The baby was showing signs of stress.
Oh, God. Where's Allison? She should be with me.
What's he doing here? I thought I told you not to call
him. How is she?
You've got a lot of nerves showing
George,
up here
please.
After everything.
George, please. How is Trisha?
All I know is she's in delivery and they're both stable. We just have to wait.
Everything's fine. Your wife came through with flying colors. She's resting now.
How was the baby?
It was a touch and go there for a while, but your son's a fighter.
My son?
Congratulations. It's a boy.
Thank you, doctor. Can I see them?
No, you may not.
Doctor?
My daughter doesn't want you anywhere near her baby.
I am not your husband, and this is not your family.
It isn't.
The issues between me and my wife are ours.
Ex-wife.
I bet you're proud of yourself for doing the devil's work, huh? This is all you're doing. Don't try to ruin her life because yours wasn't perfect.
Mr. Life, she is resting now, and she's pretty sedated. She'll wake soon, but will still be a little foggy. Your son, he's in the nursery, though.
Okay, all right. Hey, let's go. Let's go see your little brother, huh? Come on.
It's okay.
Hey, look. Look. Right there. Right there. Look. Hey.
David.
You did great.
Yeah, is the baby okay?
Yes.
Okay.
Beautiful.
Oh.
He's a fighter already.
Mom? Did you see him?
Yes, baby. He's gorgeous. Now, I'm going to go get the doctor so he can come in and check on you.
Okay. Is everything okay? She seems a little weird.
Yeah, everything's just fine.
What is it, you guys? Is the baby okay?
You asked for David when you were waking up.
I did.
Just think it took her by surprise.
It didn't help. It just told her to shut up, too.
John, what?
He did? My mama?
He told her off real good, too.
John.
What?
She just hasn't really been herself since.
You mean it? He'll see me?
You're good to go.
Thank you, John, man. I can't tell you what this means to me, man. I appreciate it.
Hey, listen to me, though, man. This guy doesn't mess around, so stay on your toes.
I will. Don't worry.
I mean it, David. You're only going to get one shot, all right? So make it count.
I am all over it, man.
All right. Good luck.
John, thank you, man. Thanks again. David Life, sir. I'm David Life. David Life. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for the app. Mr. Bell, can I call you Chris?
Hello?
All right, you okay? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sir?
All right. I won't let you down, sir. Oh, yeah, sure. All right. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for the app.
Sir? Hello? Are you all right?
Sure, thank you.
Sir, this facility is for guests only.
I was just leaving. Yo! Hey, yo! Yo! Hey! That's my car! Hey! My car!
Tribune Pharmaceuticals, how can I help you?
This is David Life. I have an appointment this afternoon with Mr. Chris Bell.
Yes, Mr. Life, I have you right here.
Yes, I was calling to let you know I'm having some car trouble. I'm going to be a few minutes late.
How late do you think you'll be?
5-10 minutes tops.
Well, just so you know, he has to be out of the office no later than 4:30 today.
I totally understand. Thank you. David Life, I have an appointment with Chris Bell.
Yes, Mr. Life. I'm sorry you just missed him.
What?
He really waited as long as he could.
Oh, you're kidding.
I can check the schedule for you.
Listen, tomorrow or anytime this week, I'm available if he's available. I'm here.
Okay, I'm checking.
Okay.
I'm so sorry. It looks like Mr. Bell is actually booked up for the next 3 weeks, but I can try and reschedule you then.
I don't have 3 weeks.
I'm sorry.
Hi, this is John. Leave me a message and I'll get back to you.
John, hey, how are you? It's me again. Sorry for leaving so many messages. Okay, it was 1 minute, you know, it was one lousy minute. You know what? Forget it.
Looks like that was a fine suit this time. Probably still clean up nice.
Yeah, I wouldn't do anything, all right?
Hey, I never said you were. I just thought you might be a little hungry. Nick makes the best chili in Atlanta. Of course, I could be a little biased, because I order it every day.
Yeah, I'm all right.
Well, maybe you could take it for later.
Don't need your charity, man.
It's not charity.
Ellen, what is it?
Just a kindness.
Kindness. What's the difference?
Well, put it this way. A lot of people do charitable things because they think it's something to do or it makes them feel good. But when you do a little kindness, it's an opportunity to bring a little light into the world so people can see a little better.
You sound like a preacher, man.
Guilty. Pastor Richard Taylor.
I know it. David Life.
Well, it's good to meet you, David. I'll tell you what, I'll just set this down right here. And just know, it's getting cold. It would be a shame to let Nick's chili go to waste. It's really good chili. All right, I'll leave you to it.
Guess I could eat something.
Hey, David. One last thing. At the bottom of that bag, you're gonna find my card. My church is just across the street here, so if you have time, come on by me.
Yeah, I'll see.
Nice suit. Really nice suit.
Hey, I told y'all to stop. But nothing. I'll be right back.
How you doing? Excuse me. Could you spare a dollar, ma'am? Just trying to get a little gas money.
Yeah. Here. Take care.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I know. I saw the whole thing, okay? Look, I just want to help.
I'm fine. I just need to sit, okay?
But gosh, you're bleeding. Let me take a look at that. Come on, man. You could really be hurt. I mean, we got to get you checked out. At least let me call somebody, like a family or a friend. Come on, man. There has to be somebody. He can help.
Sam, I just got your message. I was on my way.
Hey, Dad. Hey.
Look, honey, we talked about this. You should have waited for me.
I know, but it was just a few blocks.
David? Are you okay? Are you hurt?
Dad?
Well, naturally, in a city of 500,000 people, of course. I'm sorry. David, this is my daughter, Samantha.
Call me Sam.
I was supposed to be on the way to school, but...
Look, you told me to gas up before I got on the freeway, remember?
All right. Samantha, this is David.
Hi.
Who looked a whole lot better last time I saw him. And we gotta get your suit cleaned. But in the meantime, let's fix you up.
I'm fine. Just a little sore.
Please, do not tell me that my disobedient daughter's act of kindness will go for naught.
Another kindness?
You know, that was one of my favorite sermons.
You need Dodge. All right, you're in enough trouble.
Okay, then I gotta go then, right? I should...
Yeah, you should go. You should go. 1 second. All right, look.
We'll
just drive safe, okay?
Okay. You know, it's like I can feel the
prisons. Yeah. Hey, call me when you get there.
Will do. I love you.
Love you.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Thank you.
Bye, David.
All right. Straight to school. All right. Kids, come on. Let's fix you up. So you want to tell me what happened?
Just a misunderstanding.
Gotta be careful out there.
I'm doing my best.
Still have your office space behind Danny's diner?
Moving around a bit. here and there.
Okay. Need some more.
Whose presence?
What?
Your daughter. She said she felt her presence.
You heard that. You know, when folks are whispering, it's not polite to listen.
What'd she mean?
There. That's her hold you. So, David, you hungry?
Something you don't want to tell me?
Her mother. She felt the presence of her mother when she found you.
I'm sorry.
So am I. Every day. Come on, let's get you something to eat. I guess.
You run a shelter?
Yeah, we do what we can. It's my wife's vision. It didn't become possible until her death, but people in the community heard about what she was trying to do, and they helped out.
It's a lot of people.
There's a lot more that we can't even take in.
Yeah, I don't get it. What's that got to do with me?
When we lost Evelyn, Sam... Well, she put it upon herself to carry on her mother's vision. And, frankly, it worries me to death, David. She can be a little spontaneous about who she decides to help.
Like you said, gotta be careful.
Which I warned her about many times. But now and again, she meets someone. Someone who has a particular need. And when she does... That's when she says she feels her mother's presence. I can't explain it. I doubt she can either, but it's real for her. Let's get you set up.
Hey, can I get a kit?
How'd you sleep?
Good, thanks.
So, any plans?
Same as every day, you know. Look for a job.
No, I have an in with the Salvation Army. They leave their donated clothing here sometimes, so makes it easier for the men to change into clean clothes.
Well, I guess I could use a new look.
Yeah. Well, in the hall, big room, can't miss it.
Thanks.
Hey, David. Good luck on the job search.
Listen, I was wondering if you think it'd be okay if I stayed another night.
See you tonight.
All right.
My man, just got a call, Tyrone. Hello. Hey, guys, so we're going to have a lot of people coming in, so we're going to need some. David, great to see you. We're running out of sleeping bags. I was wondering if you can go and grab some from the storage closet in the chapel. All right. There you go.
Thank you. All right, guys. Who goes shopping? I mean, what's up? Yellow? Hey, heading out?
Yeah, just wanted to stop by and, say thanks for the suit.
Will we be seeing you tonight?
If that's okay.
You've been a great deal of help these last few days.
Well, just trying to do my part, yeah.
Well, believe me, you've done more than your part.
Well, I don't want to disturb you.
Trust me, I'd rather be doing anything else. I'm like a dinosaur when it comes to filling out online forms. So.
What kind of forms?
I'm trying to get a loan so we can expand this place. Bring in some more homeless at night. You know, add a classroom, bathroom, maybe change the furniture.
Yeah, sounds great.
Yeah, well, it's also giving me a migraine.
You mind if I take a look?
Are you serious?
I mean, I don't know if I can do anything, but...
Please, pull up a chair. Let me see here. Let me get back to this screen. I cannot get off of this.
Okay. Let me see.
See, this is...
Yeah, see here, you skipped some sections. You gotta answer these questions before you can move on.
I barely understand any of this, so...
Yeah, I know it sounds like mumbo-jumbo, but it's all pretty standard once you get familiar with the terms the bank uses.
Okay, like what?
Well, first things first, let's finish this. Mm. Do you have your financials handy?
Yes.
So, how's school going?
It's good. It's senior year.
Mm. So you're gonna come back and help your dad after you graduate?
I thought about it, but I decided to join the Salvation Army. I spent the last two summers working with them, and I really like it.
So that's what your dad meant when he said he had an in.
He told you about that, huh? Well, I told them what we were doing over here, so they were happy to donate the clothes.
Well, it's made a big difference. Not if I can just find a job.
Well, don't give up, David. I mean, I believe in you.
Why'd you help me? I mean, you didn't know who I was, if I was dangerous or high.
Sure I did.
How?
You... Yeah, it wouldn't make any sense.
Your father said you felt a certain way about people, like a presence or something. I'm sorry if that's personal.
No, I don't mind. You know, this place, it was my mother's dream. We lost her before she could see it come true.
What happened to her?
She went out one afternoon, like she always did, you know, into the community, just helping wherever she could. This time there was a junkie. He came up behind her. She died right there in the streets.
I'm so sorry.
See, the thing is, this was very, very personal for her. Her father was homeless. I mean, that's how she understood. That's why she wasn't afraid to go out. She taught me that, like her father, everybody deserves a second chance. And all these people, they have lives and memories and loved ones and stories. And sometimes when I'm out, I can feel their stories like I felt yours.
You felt my story.
Yeah, well, maybe I'm not saying it right. It's more like I can feel her presence beside me, and she's telling me that your story's not done yet, that you've lost your way and you've lost your faith, and I just have to get you here just to help you get it back. Does that make any sense?
More than you know.
Hey, David.
What does he want from me?
What do you mean?
I made a mistake, yeah. I was selfish. I was stupid. Worst of all, I betrayed the trust of the people that love me. Them because of it. I've done everything to make up for it. I would give anything to have them back. It's still no good, you know? Nothing's changed. So here I sit. I just want to know, you know, what does he want from me?
I don't know, David. There was a time when my life was turned upside down. And I asked myself the same question.
Did you get your answer?
Not the kind you mean. I came to understand that you can't put a timetable on faith. You have to believe, no matter how much he wants or how long it takes, all things work together for the good in the end. Because you love him.
Was that enough? You lost your wife.
Losing Evelyn really tested my faith. Well, this place, you know, continuing her work, got me to a place I can find peace in that loss.
I just want my family back.
And I have faith you will get them back. But David, you have to have faith too.
She is. What a surprise. How are you?
I'm good.
You ready for your big day? You excited?
Are you kidding? I can't wait. I mean, you are still coming, aren't you?
Absolutely. Wouldn't miss it for the world. What brings you here?
Well, Sam surprised me, so I'm gonna take her out for a pre-graduation lunch.
Ah.
Dad's taking me to Mannion.
Fancy.
Well, how often does your one and only daughter graduate from college?
Congratulations again.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Very welcome. See you tomorrow.
Okay.
All right.
Give me 1 minute.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I know it's none of my business, but I really do think it's time for you to make that next step.
Oh. I don't know. Yeah.
Okay. Well, I got you something in my office to help you make up your mind.
Sinking like a stone. You're all that I need.